So you want to learn how to install mods on Red Dead, right? Well, luckily for you, I am here today to show you exactly how to do that. So first, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to reddeadredemption2mods.com, or you can just go in Google, type in Lennys Simple, Lennys Simple Trainer, and it should just be the first link right here up at the top. So now that we're on the page, it's gonna have all these features right here. It'll show you exactly what you can do. And typically when they add new stuff, it'll be right at the top and it'll say new in bold. Then it'll explain what the new feature is. If you scroll down, it's gonna show you the controls. So the default for Lennys when you first open the game is gonna be F5. I believe you can change that, but I usually keep it on F5 because the other mods I dedicate to different hotkeys. So it's gonna show you menu controls, bodyguard controls, and the installation is always gonna be usually at the top or the bottom of these mod pages. So if you ever forget something or forget what files to drag in, it'll be right here. And also whenever you download these mods, it's usually gonna come with a README file as well, which will also explain exactly what you need to drag into the folder. Another useful thing on this Lennys Simple Trainer page right here is at the very bottom, it has all these links to lists of character models, weapon models, teleport coordinates, vehicle models, and player actions. So these are gonna come in handy if you plan on taking pictures or videos, or if you just wanna make anything related to Red Dead. This is gonna allow you to put in a bunch of different codes for a bunch of different things. So now we're gonna scroll back up to the top, and we have this message up here that says, please make sure you have the latest ASI loader. So if you click on that, it's gonna take you to this ASI loader page. Now you're gonna wanna download both this file and the Lennys Simple Trainer. So we're gonna go back over to Lennys, and you're gonna click download this file right here up at the top. And it's gonna go in order usually of when it was last updated. So it's gonna have the dates right here. So we know that August 17th, this was the latest one. So we're gonna go ahead and click download. Everything should just pop up right here at the bottom. It'll usually take about 5 seconds, which isn't too long. So that'll be down there. Then we're gonna go back over to ASI. We're gonna download this one. Same rules apply. We can see that the latest one was April 29th. So we're gonna go ahead and click download. Now that we have these two at the bottom here, we're gonna go ahead and open both of them. So now that we have these two mods installed, you're gonna wanna click on them, and then you're gonna want to extract the zip folder. So I personally have BreeZip. This is a free application on the Microsoft Store. You never have to pay for it. So I use this, but you can use whatever as long as it works to extract zip files. So you're gonna press extraction, and then right here you can change wherever you want to place the file. I typically do my desktop just so it's easy to find. So then after you pick where you want to extract it, you'll press extract. And same thing applies for this one. So I have both of them right here on my desktop already. So this is what your Lennys Simple Trainer file is going to look like. This has the README, which I mentioned earlier. So this says, put all your files in the game root. When the game launches, you should hear a few beeping sounds. Now this is very important because when you load up your game, if you do not have those beeping sounds, the mod is not installed correctly. So you want to make sure to look out for that. So we're gonna ahead and close this. Even though it says drag all of these files, you don't necessarily need the README. You can keep it if you'd like to. It's not gonna mess up your game, but you can drag all of these into your Red Dead folder. My Red Dead folder is installed on my D drive right here. You can see where my folder is located. Now yours might be under your C drive or wherever you installed it. I believe you can check that on the Rockstar Game Launcher, which is what I use. After you drag all of those in here, you're gonna want to open the ASI loader as well. This also has the same README, and all you need for this one is the version.dll folder, okay? So we're gonna take this file, drag it right into our Red Dead folder. And once that's good to go, then we have one more cool mod that I'm gonna show you guys. We're gonna head over to Nexus Mods. Now, Nexus Mods has so many cool mods for pretty much every game you can think of. GTA, Skyrim. I believe Skyrim has like probably over 50 million downloads of mods. So this is the place you wanna be. If you wanna look through Nexus Mods yourself, that is totally fine. They have anything from new horse coats to firearm cosmetics. They have a map editor, and apparently they have this corpse spawn distance, which is interesting. But anyway, we're gonna go back over to Rampage Trainer, and the same rules apply. So everything is gonna be by date right here. This one, I'm gonna click manual download. Now this thing is gonna pop up. It's gonna say Alexander Blades Scripthook, and this is what you're gonna need to install as well. So once you click that, it's gonna take you to this page. The date's gonna be right here. So you can see when the last time it was updated, and then you're just gonna click this download link right here. Do not click this one. This one says for developers, so you're not gonna need that one. Go ahead and click download. It'll pop right up here at the bottom. Then we're gonna go back over to Rampage Trainer. We're gonna click download. Same thing, it'll pop up right here. And if you have an account through Nexus Mods, you can just click slow download. It's 5 seconds, it's not that long, guys. So it'll go really quick. And then we're gonna do the same thing all over again. So we're gonna open these files and we're going to extract them, okay? After you extract them, this is what the folders are gonna look like. So your Rampage is going to look like this, okay? This is another README. You don't need this in your game, like I said. So you're just gonna wanna drag these two files into your Red Dead folder. So after you've done that, you're gonna wanna go over to your Scripthook folder. Again, same thing, README. Now you're gonna go into bin. You don't need this native trainer ASI folder. This is another trainer that you can add to your game. I typically don't use this one only because I feel like Rampage is a little easier and more fun to use and maybe a little bit more detailed. Honestly, I feel like whenever I had native trainer, it just did not work with my game, and I think the hotkeys just it just got all messed up. So I'm not personally gonna use that one, but you can feel free to. What we're gonna do is we're gonna drag this file right here and this Scripthook file both into our Red Dead folder right here, okay? So after you've done that, everything should be good to go, and you're gonna go to your Rockstar game launcher and you're gonna start up the game. So make sure to listen for those beeping sounds. All right, there we go. So we heard that, so that's a good sign. All right, guys, so now that we've loaded up the game, I'm going to give you a warning. Do not go to online when you have mods installed in your game. This is either going to mess your game up or it is going to ban you from online because it's going to think that you're trying to do illegal shit. So please do not do that. So we're gonna go right into story. Waiting for the game to load, oh, oh. Waiting for the game to load, oh. So now that we have the game loaded up, typically what's gonna happen is it's gonna have this pop-up message that'll say welcome. It's gonna be from the native trainer. To get rid of it, you can either press A or enter. It's just gonna have user agreements, stuff like that. After you've gotten through that, you're gonna go ahead and press F5. Now when you press F5, the Rampage Trainer is gonna come up as well. And I'm gonna show you exactly how to change the hotkey so that these two mods aren't interfering with each other. But for right now, I have F5 dedicated to Lennys and I have F6 dedicated to Rampage. So you can see Lennys, we have player, weapons, bodyguard, horses. There's a lot of cool stuff with this mod. I don't really use it anymore just because Rampage has expanded so much. You can do so much on there. You can spawn anything, objects, horses, NPCs. So we're gonna go to F6. So now I will show you how to change the hotkey. So you're gonna go all the way down to settings. And right here at the bottom, it's gonna say open key. So like I said, I have mine on F6. So to change it, you'll just press enter and you'll type in any hotkey that you wanna change it to. So I'm gonna press F6, enter. Now it's set on that hotkey. Hopefully I explained everything enough for you guys. If not, please leave a comment down below. Let me know if you have any questions. And I will be uploading how-tos every Friday. So the next how-to is going to be how to use these mods. So how to use Lennys, how to use Rampage, and I will show you exactly what you can spawn. It's pretty crazy. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope to see you in the next video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.